this marriage. Fix the man, fix the boy up. You got a Cadillac, got all the authority, got you a nice wife, got you a nice home. That's how God wanted man to be. Now, uh-oh, what happened? You got some kids coming in here now. Uh-oh. Verse 50, and Joseph was born, and until Joseph was born, two sons. Before the famine came, which Asenath, the daughter of Potiphar's priest of On, bare unto him. Joseph called the name of the firstborn Manasseh, for God said, what? God had made me forget all that I've been through. And when a man has a son, it does something for him. You all right, Brother Curtis? Got me a man here. A little man here. Wow. Chest all out. Dad's chest all out. Gonna buy him everything I can find. got me a son, so I'm forgetting about what happened to me in the past. And that's why he gave him that name, that God has made me forget all of that I've been through. And not only did they sell me into a hole, put me in a hole and sell me into slavery, but look at what the man did. They put me in a hole down here. Ooh, prison and mistreated me. Almost got me killed. And all because of what they did to me. Look what I've been through. But then he says, now I'm married, got me a girl, got me going on, I'm exercising my authority, and got me a son. Happy. But still, there was a little bit of remembrance. Just a little bit of hurt still in there. Praise God. But he got a son. Praise God. And he says, all right, verse, and he had, he forgot all my father's house. All my father's house. That's, he forgot about his father's house, but he did not forget what God was doing for him. See, forgetting my father's house is one thing, but for now I don't forget about who my God is. Mm-hmm. I'm still living for my God. Me and my God still have a relationship. So sometimes your kinfolks, and sometimes that's the best tool the devil's got. Mm-hmm. Best weapon he's got. Hit you upside the head one of your relatives. Oh man, I ain't gonna ever do nothing like that to me. Well, there it is. And then, verse 52, and the name of the second called Ephraim, for God had caused me to be what?
Fruitful.
In the land of my. Now, are we talking about kids? Are we talking about wealth? Wealth and kids. Yeah. In the land of my affliction, I'm multiplying my family, and by this time, I done got a lot of stuff stored up for Pharaoh. I got a lot of stuff. His plan is working. If his plan wasn't working, Pharaoh wouldn't say, you ain't marrying nobody. You can't, you know, if the plan was a failure, Joseph was still broke. Joseph, we're not getting anywhere. What, I thought you said you had a plan. Yeah, so Pharaoh what? Saw the plan, saw the results of the plan, and say, you know what? You're worth somebody what? Marrying. That's another clue. They said, brothers don't get married until someone can see that you are worth what? They can see. Broke Joker come up to me and sit down and say, hey brother, Mr. Williams, may I marry your daughter?
Nope.
I have no education, no work, got my hat on this way, can't want to keep my pants on, several tattoos. Will you give your daughter to me in marriage? You know? Brothers have to prove that they are worth somebody's what? Dollar. Woo! That's another coffee and donuts you guys.
That's a dozen.
You're making a cake, don't you?
That's a dozen donuts.
So that's what Pharaoh saw. Guys got it going on. You give him somebody's daughter. Got it going on.
Keep him out.
I should charge this one. Oh, don't do it this way, that way. That's the old school.